Welcome to the Herschel Hi-Fi video series. The tutorial called Inspecting the Hi-Fi On and Off Spectra is about showing the difference between the two kinds of spectra and where to find them in an observation context. The on spectra are the observation when the telescope was pointing at the source. The off spectra, on the other hand, are obtained either when the telescope was pointing on a dedicated blank sky position, also known as the reference position, or when the instrument was looking at the internal code load. Therefore, the off spectrum is observing mode dependent. For instance, for the DBS, it is the difference between the two CHEP spectra. For point mode position switch, it emulates the blank sky position observed against the internal cold load. For point mode frequency switch, it is a single blank sky position observed in frequency switching mode. For point mode load CHEP, it is the difference between the blank sky position and the cold load. For spectral map mode, you will find one off spectrum pair map for a fixed target, but for a moving target, you will find several off spectra pair map. These off will also be moving on the sky at the same rate as the moving target. And finally, for spectral scan mode, you will find one off pair LO tuning. In level 1, the data contain both the on and the off spectra. If you look at the summary table from a given spectrometer, you will see the source and the off observation identified here as science in the type column. The difference between the source and the off datasets are identified by the IS line column. If it is a source observation, the IS line will be set to true, and for the off position, it will be set to false. In our example, amongst the science datasets, number 5 is the on spectra, number 6 is the off spectra, and so on. Although both the source and the off spectra are processed by the level 2 pipeline, only the source data is retained in level 2. However, the off spectra are nevertheless kept and stored in the calibration pipeline out reference spectra product. It is important to examine the reference spectra because they can indicate the presence of line emission in the off spectra, which could affect the on-source spectra. Note that the reference spectra are most often affected by standing waves because they do not benefit from the same instrument drift cancellation scheme than the on spectra. Indeed, in essence, it is the subtraction of the off spectra from the on-source spectra that allows the cancellation out of those artifacts. Therefore, it is recommended to correct the off spectra for standing waves and baseline drift, just like it is justified to correct the level 2 data. As an example, we show in the lower panel the CHEP position of this observation being affected by contamination. The result is seen in the upper panel, where the level 2 data features what resemble an absorption line exactly at the frequency of the narrow emission line in the off spectrum. This is in fact the result of the on minus the off scheme and reveals that this negative dip is in reality an off-source contamination rather than a genuine line absorption component. This post-processing step will ensure that you can identify any contamination that could be hidden by the standing wave affecting the data in your off spectra. If contamination is found, you will then be able to take action in order to correct your data. For detailed instruction, you can access the Herschel Library website, where documentation for all aspects of the Herschel project has been assembled. In the Hi-Fi section, you will find the following relevant documents. You should consult the Hi-Fi Data Reduction Guide cookbooks and the handbook, where some recipes are made available to help you with processing Hi-Fi data and learn how to correct the data affected by contamination. Thank you.